Welcome back, it's me, Lou. I'm here for another action figure unboxing and review. Today from Mattel, we are featuring the Street Shark Ripster. Caution, power punching action, press my fin if you dare. And let's try that out, as it suggests in the back. So the cool thing with this package design, it's kind of interactive. It allows you to play with the figure to demonstrate its play feature. And you pull down on the fin, and then the mouth moves, which is awesome. So I was really excited when I found this at my local Target. Street Sharks was a line of action figures that came out, I believe, in the mid-90s. At the time, I was either in high school or just starting college. And I wasn't really fully collecting action figures outside of maybe just like Star Wars, Power of the Force, and some Transformers. But I was very aware of Street Sharks, and I was kind of appreciated them from a distance. And over the years, prior to the re-release of the new line, I was always trying to kind of hunting them down on eBay. But the figures were always beat up, and the ones that were really nice were ridiculously expensive. So when Mattel came out with this, you know, new line of toys, I was all on board, and at the very least, I wanted to get Ripster, and we'll go from there. You know, if I like the line enough, I might collect more of them, but I just kind of wanted Ripster, because I kind of feel like he's kind of like the poster child for Street Sharks. You know, it's a very evergreen, iconic character design. Beautiful artwork on the back, and much like also like the Masters of the Universe packaging, you know, they highlight the play features in addition to the cool poster-like illustration. Press the fin to make me bite. Pull back, or pull fist back until arm is straight and waist twist all the way to the side. Then release for a power punch. Other figures are jab and slash. Bite is might. They climbed out of the deep and onto the street to stop the gene juggling madman, Dr. Pyranoid, and his Seviots from devastating Fission City with a tidal wave of crime. So Ripster, bite is might, the natural born leader of the Street Sharks. He's bull, he's tough, he's a wild-blooded hero with a fist-like freight train. Sharks obey him. He needs no weapons except the ones he was born with because of his skill in martial arts. He specializes in a combination of bite boxing and si kwan do. His main shoes, motorcycles, barbells, monster trucks, and submarine sandwiches. So let's take this out. Very, very excited for this. I bought this maybe a month ago, and it's just now I'm getting around to it. Life's been busy, so I don't always have time to check out my toys ASAP, so this is going to be a treat for me. And I am loving what I'm seeing right now. The cage accessory by itself, I think, is well worth the price of admission. And this is just looking fantastic. Let's get all these ties off of them. Man, this guy has so many ties keeping him down. And we are still not done. Jeez Louise. Okay, got all this garbage out of the way, and let's take a look at the figure. First off, I gotta say, I love the shark cage. Even though it lacks a bottom piece, it's still really, really sick. This thing is cool as... Man. Wait, is there a bottom piece? Am I missing something? No, there is no bottom piece, just the top. But what it looks like these things are modular, because it almost looks like you could disconnect them and reassemble it. So maybe you can stack them on top of each other, because the pieces here are interlockable with the pieces on top. So I think if you have enough of these, you could probably make a full cage or even make a crazy giant cage. But this is cool. It's large enough the whole the Street Shark. And then I got to check this out. It's large enough to hold like Marvel Legends figures. So if you wanted to like encase Venom or like any other like Marvel Legends figure, it's going to be a tight fit, but they do fit inside of it. And the head kind of peeks out on top. Or if you're into like professional wrestling and WWE, you can recreate those kind of matches where the manager or valet has to be outside in a shark cage. So yeah, I'm digging this a lot. A lot of play value in the shark cage alone. As for the figure itself, it looks great. As I highlighted at the start of the video, if you pull on the fin, the mouth is articulated and kind of like chomps down. It's made of like a soft rubber. And my only concern with this is that, you know, over time, rubber does degrade. It's not as like durable as plain plastic. So I'm kind of wondering, like, you know, say 10 years from now, if this starts to dry rot and crack. But, you know, I don't think that's something you necessarily have to worry about, especially if you're a child and you just want to play with it. But it's really cool. The facial expression's amazing, as is the sculpting. It's a really neat figure. In terms of the articulation and play features, you'll notice as soon as you handle him that his waist is spring-loaded, so he can throw punches either way. His arms are articulated as well. It's kind of the same articulation scheme you expect from like a Mattel Masters of the Universe figure. So you have the articulated shoulders, elbow bend, elbow swivel, articulated wrists, swivels at the waist with spring-loaded action, and the legs are articulated as well, as are the knees. Unfortunately, there are no peg holes, so you can't really use a display stand, which is unfortunate because this figure is very, very top heavy, and I kind of feel like you're not going to be able to display it on your shelf unless you put it inside the shark cage. Because one thing I'm noticing is that I can't even get the legs to go straight down, so he's always going to be kind of hunched forward, and due to his heavy weight, it's always just going to lean forward and tip over. So unless you have some magic secret for keeping this guy standing up, you know, good luck. I'd suggest maybe applying sticky tack, and that'll probably hold him down. But yeah, very top heavy figure. Size comparison, here he is next to a Marvel Legends. And if you're into like TMNT and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, I think this is a great, piece that you can display alongside that. Just to carry over that whole anthropomorphic animal humanoid form theme. But overall, a fantastic figure. Fun play features, especially if you're a child. And they're so excellent and well-crafted. And I'm so glad that they're back. And who knows, maybe I'll dip my toes and grab another one. The one I really want is Moby Lick, the Orca. So hopefully in due time, we'll get that figure sooner than later. But yeah, I can't recommend this line enough. If you're nostalgic for Street Sharks, and if this is a toy line you grew up with, count your blessings, because in 2024, they're back, and it's awesome that you can find these on shelves. Alright, so with that being said, let's wrap this one up. Once again, my name is Lou. If you're new to my channel, welcome. If you are a returning viewer or subscriber, thank you so much for your continued support. I greatly appreciate it. So until the next video, be safe, take care of yourself, buy lots of toys, and most importantly, be happy. And I'll see you at the next one. All right, later.